मुंबई और पुणे में 1987 से कई अनोखे जुर्मों की सूचनाएं दी गई हैं।
5 करोड़ नकद से भरा हुआ बैग एक जुए के अड्डे में पाया गया। उसी रात विक्रम उर्फ जॉनी जी की गोली मार कर हत्या की गई।
नोटोरियस क्रिमिनल लाइक तुंगेकर हैज सरेंडर्ड हिमसेल्फ टू द पुलिस फॉर किलिंग हिज पार्टनर हरमन खत्री एंड वाइफ कोको।
सीरियल किलर रमन राघव ने लोहे की छड़ से 30 लोगों की बेरहमी से हारिका के तथाकथित प्रेमी करण सिंह की लाश एक गुफा में पाई।
On a highway near Pune, a car recently crashed and exploded when its windscreen was hit by a rabbit.
Question is, what is the source of all these mysterious crimes?
This is Sri Ram Raghavan, a notorious and vicious fiction fanatic, charged and guilty of crafting some of the most mind-bending thrillers in modern cinema. Don't be fooled by his unassuming style. He is a mastermind of crime. His most notable acts are Johnny Gaddar, Ek Haseena Thi, Agent Vinod and Badlapur. His latest exploit, Andhadhun, has been bagging many awards. Eyewitnesses have said that after watching it, they couldn't trust their own eyes. A serial breeder. Sriram spends his time devouring books, watching movies and plotting devious crimes. The question is, will we ever be able to decode Sriram's mind? Brace yourselves. It is indeed a mysterious, cryptic, baffling, perplexing, and inexplicable mind that we explore today.
The first thing you hear is that da-da-da-da. We see a rabbit, and the rabbit is getting hunted. This guy, our blind piano player, is playing it. So this Beethoven piece had a certain dramatic fascination for Sriram.
I grew up in Pune. I did my school, college in Pune. So I've spent a lot of time in Pune. I know the city. I've seen it change so much. I just felt that it might be nice to capture the beautiful part of Pune. You know, the parts which may slowly disappear in the next 10 years or so, it may all go. So it was like more like just for fun, nostalgia for me also.
We had all kinds of theatres.
There is Alpana, there is Vasant, there is Bhanu Vilas, there is Shri Krishna, Nishad, Empire.
Alankar, you show a lot of where Eagles Dare and Guns of Navarone.
I call them filmy keedas, you know. They would attend the first day, first show. Agar front row mein bhi mil raha hai, it didn't matter. Pata chalna chahiye ki film mein kya hai. So Sriram is one of the original filmy keedas. He has films in his blood.
Now,
Johnny?
He's an absolute directory of films that even today, like, I mean, if I have anything, any doubt about any film, the first call I make is to Sriram. When we are discussing a scene, like, I mean, I'll say, let's do it this way. He'll tell me, no, this is already done in this so-and-so film. Then he'll tell me 3 other films. He's like, this particular aspect of what we are doing is done or treated like this in 3 different films. Now we have to find a 4th way of doing it.
I remember one of the things he said to me, you need to know what work is already happening or other people have done. So, you know, you have to figure out another way to tell your own story.
I lived in this room, he lived in that room. I didn't live alone in this room. Like Raju was staying here, Bishnoi was staying here, Mohanan. Yeah, we all used to be sprawled in this room and Shriram was the regal Maharaja living in that room. So, I mean, unfortunately, a very low budget version of all the other brothers out there.
Abbas Mustan.
Abbas Mustan, Warner Brothers, Marx Brothers, lots of brothers.
Ambanis.
Your first five attempts at any dialogue will not pass muster with Shriram. It's full of unnecessary explanation and his exposition and it's a whole bunch of things. So you realize by and by what he's trying to do, that you dig deeper. So in that sense, that process is not easy for everyone.
We sit and jam. So it's not like we're doing some heavy duty work like lifting boulders or something, you know. So we just enjoy it.
And like in Andhadhun, you know, we came to the point where he's running away from when Manohar comes to kill him. What happens to him when he runs away? After that, took around 9 months to come to the end.
We had no idea what to do. We just knew that we don't want to have blind man will take revenge with the help of girlfriend or blind man will take revenge with the help of the little boy. These were the thoughts that everyone would have expected, I think. And Shriram was like, no, we are not going there. Then the organ mafia came in at a certain point and people said, what is this? It becomes so sordid. But you stick with whatever you think resonates and eventually something happens.
Isko kaise malum? Mere haath mein Shankar Bhagwan
hai. Over a 3-hour discussion, if you get one or two ideas, it's not bad at all. When Shriram shoots something, it's been elaborately, beautifully constructed. There is a certain grammar which has gone into the construct, a certain thought process.
Shiga, wait kar rahe ho. Hey. Tumhara dost nahi aayega.
Kaun dost ko?
No scene can be removed, no line can be removed. Everything is there for a reason. If you remove something, something falls. It's like a house of cards.
For Andhadhun, I think that the murder cleanup sequence was the one that Shriram sort of built from, really. That's the one that he wanted to make the movie for. Then it was sort of figured out what Akash's character is, what Simi's character is, what their quirks are. And for Badlapur, it was about the transformation of a man you didn't expect to get transformed.
You have a scene, you call your DOP, sound guy, then you call your assistants, you call your actors. Everybody's going to have an opinion on the scene. So my thing is, the more people who are able to add their thoughts to it, it just helps me make it better.
There's no point in telling Shriram that let's close on the idea. You will say, hey, okay, close. Next day you can say that, no, it's open again. So that's the point.
I think he exhausts everyone else around.
One of my co-writers can get infuriated saying, yeah, this is already good, why are we tweaking it or touching it.
Different people say it at different stages of the film and say, nahi, ye theek hai.
But the very fact we're doing it means there's something in it which is bothering me, maybe. No.
Boss, this is close, na? We thought this will happen. No, I was just thinking that, hey, we'd have it this way.
Yes, he's an overthinker.
The thing is getting cooked till the time it is being eaten.
So I do it for purely selfish reasons. So nothing else.
Now, libraries have relatively come down compared to how many there were back then, you know?
We were all hungry for stories. And we used to go regularly on these forays, you know, to check books on the footpaths of Fountain Sion. We had spent hours, you know, sitting on the ground and going through every book.
We used to just go there on a Sunday and just buy whatever we feel might be interesting, and we used to come back with literally sometimes 30, 40 books. The joy of just walking around looking at books is something.
There are people I normally say ki, like, I've learned a lot from, but I don't want to be him. Sriram is something which I would love to be because of the peace that man has, which is a kind of a, I mean, I don't know, you attained that nirvana at some stage which Sriram has probably attained at an earlier stage. I don't know.
Oh, I don't know about him. He is very sattvic. I can tell you that the rest of us are like, come on, make movies faster because we also need to work. Sriram, I think, is very basic. He's a very simple person in many ways.
Without trying to get hyperbolic and everything, in older times, I think we used to call such guys Rishi. In the sense, they had a very dedicated focus and all their life they worked towards that focus. So Sriram possibly would be a Rishi of beat thrillers. All his life he wanted to do beat thrillers, but unfortunately they're becoming A thrillers.
I never doubted that I will not do it. So I always knew some aaj kal kabhi na kabhi to hoga, but I didn't know how, what, whatever. But I mean, I had a lot of patience and I was at it. See, as long as you don't have to pay rent, you can live and you can cook and you can wash your own clothes, you can live pretty okay in Bombay. You know, you don't need too much money. So I have to just take care of myself and my whatever vices.
We see a rabbit and the rabbit is getting hunted. Sriram came and saw and was like, oh, I don't know, it's not working. Then one day, the Vivaldi piece I had put and he said, okay, this seems good.
For this particular classical piece, Sriram and Sanjay, they have flown down a French violinist, Angie. She came down and she dubbed the Vivaldi.
Suspense is something very intangible. I try to give away as much as possible to the audience and still keep enough aces up my sleeve. I don't think any director would be able to say, okay, this is my style, this is the way I do it. We obviously have some voice which we are trying to bring out, but I don't think I can define it.